Did you notice this part of the New Glenn booster landing? Something went seriously wrong, but they managed to correct it just in time. It could have ended really badly, but how did they pull it off?
Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started.
Blue Origin just pulled off one of the most shocking, mesmerizing, and industry-reshaping rocket recoveries we've seen in years, and the space community is still buzzing about it because on November 13th, 2025, during the maiden flight of New Glenn, the company didn't just recover its first stage booster. It delivered a landing so precise, so technically daring, and so visually unbelievable that even the most hardcore rocket fans thought they were watching a failure, right up until the very last seconds, only to realize they were witnessing a new era of reusable rocketry unfold in real time. After stage separation at around 150 kilometers, the 200 plus foot tall booster, powered by 7BE4 methane engines, reoriented itself for its fiery hypersonic plunge back into the atmosphere. And this is where things immediately began to feel different from what we've grown used to with Falcon 9 or Super Heavy landings. Because instead of using grid fins to slice through superheated plasma, New Glenn deployed its articulated aerodynamic strakes, these sleek, gliding control surfaces that Blue Origin designed specifically to avoid brutal thermal stress grid fins indoor, allowing the booster to make smoother, lower drag attitude corrections during re-entry. As the booster bled off velocity and transitioned from its entry burn into its landing burn near 10 kilometers altitude, a halo of blue plasma lit up beneath it, instantly going viral because of how dramatically different B4's methane flame looked compared to Falcon's Merlin engines, and everything seemed on track for a standard drone ship landing until suddenly it wasn't. With roughly 30 seconds left in the descent, viewers noticed something strange. The booster was not lined up with the drone ship Jacklin. In fact, it wasn't even close. It was hundreds of meters off target, drifting in the twilight sky, and live stream chats exploded with people screaming that it was going to miss the platform entirely, that the mission was about to end in a spectacular splashdown. But then, the impossible happened. The booster stopped descending vertically and began sliding sideways, almost hovering, in a maneuver so unexpected and so dramatic that for a moment, everyone watching assumed the vehicle had lost stability. What they were actually seeing was the debut of Blue Origin's power slide correction, a highly choreographed, intentionally programmed safety-first maneuver that gives New Glenn extra decision time and a larger margin for error during early reusable flights. Instead of committing to a rapid fall straight toward the deck, New Glenn's guidance computer throttled individual engines, gimbaled the thrust vector, and used pulse-level methane oxygen modulation to drift horizontally at about 5-10 meters per second, almost like watching a skyscraper glide across the ocean sky. As the booster drifted into alignment, the engines throttled back up, the lateral momentum bled off smoothly, and New Glenn settled into a perfect hover slam. Touching down at under 1 meter per second vertical velocity, an absolutely stunning sight considering the rocket's enormous mass. But the surprises didn't stop there, because as soon as the landing legs made contact with the drone ship deck, bright flashes erupted around the footpads, leaving viewers confused and worried. Only for Blue Origin to later reveal that this wasn't damage or malfunction. This was their brand new auto-weld securing system, a fully autonomous post-landing stabilization mechanism that the company had been secretly developing and testing for years. In the span of milliseconds, tungsten carbide pins blasted downward from the landing pads into pre-designed sockets in the deck, and micro-arc welding torches immediately fused the interfaces, creating a semi-permanent bond strong enough to withstand wave motions and vibrations throughout the entire towback journey. SpaceX boosters, in comparison, rely on cables, clamps, or manual securing when on land, and offshore they often rock or shift slightly with heavy seas. But Blue Origin essentially said, what if the booster just welds itself to the deck instantly? and then actually built it. A move that could dramatically shorten refurbishment time and make heavy sea recovery far safer. And it's here where the philosophical differences between Blue Origin and SpaceX become impossible to ignore. Because Falcon 9's reusability architecture is built around razor-thin margins, brutal efficiency, and zero hover landing profiles where even a few meters of error can doom a mission. Its grid fins articulate aggressively, its cooled gas thrusters make rapid corrections, and every spare kilogram matters, resulting in one of the most refined, precise recovery systems in aerospace history. Starship and Super Heavy take that intensity even further, with explosive flip maneuvers, Raptor relights, body flaps wrestling the vehicle through hyposonic air, and tower catches, attempting to snatch a 33-engine booster out of the sky with literal mechanical arms. New Glenn, on the other hand, is taking a completely different path, a more cautious, more conservative, more methodical approach that prioritizes control over efficiency, margin over minimalism, and safety over raw precision. The power slide correction is a perfect example. SpaceX boosters try to eliminate hover time entirely, but New Glenn intentionally builds hover time into its landing profile, giving the guidance system more flexibility and giving the rocket more time to assess whether the drone ship is exactly where it's supposed to be. Yes, this costs extra propellant, roughly 10 to 15% more than a Falcon 9 landing. But Blue Origin is perfectly okay with that during early flights, and the payoff is a booster that can adjust laterally in a controlled drift instead of snapping into fast, aggressive corrections. And if you zoom out and compare all three systems, Falcon, Super Heavy, and New Glenn, you end up with three totally different philosophies. SpaceX's Falcon 9 is the precise surgeon. Super Heavy is the high-energy sledgehammer pushing the boundaries of what's possible, and New Glenn is the cautious giant, moving deliberately, absorbing errors, and prioritizing robust recovery. But what makes this landing so important isn't just that Blue Origin stuck the landing, it's that they prove their entire philosophy actually works. The strakes worked, the guidance worked, the seven-engine throttle profile worked, the lateral drift worked, the auto weld worked, and the booster didn't just survive, it came back stable enough to tow across the Atlantic with zero recorded slippage. As someone who's been watching New Glenn evolve for nearly a decade, seeing it drift sideways like that honestly made my heart drop. I genuinely thought it was gone. But then watching it calmly, methodically push itself across the sky, settle over the deck, secure itself with a sci-fi welding flash, and stand there like it had been doing this for years was one of the most surreal rocket recovery moments I've ever seen. After so many delays, so many jokes, so many doubts, Blue Origin finally delivered a moment that felt historic. A recovery that wasn't just good for a first flight, but good, period. And if this is what New Glenn can do on day one, the next few years of the space race between SpaceX and Blue Origin are going to be far more intense, far more competitive, and far more exciting than anyone expected. Because, for the first time in a long time, it feels like there isn't just one company pushing the limits of reusability. Blue Origin is officially in the fight. And New Glenn's power slide landing wasn't just a recovery, it was a statement.
Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.